First of all, Indians are up at 92 wins. Rest of the way, though, Twins are surprising. And, you know, Tigers surprise me because I think that I have a feeling the Tigers are a little better than that. What stands out to you in the Central?
Well, I think the Tigers are better than that, actually. I mean, they're very right-handed, obviously. They need Victor Martinez to step up and be that left-handed bat in the middle to give them some protection against right-handed pitching. I think their starters are fine. Their bullpen is solid with K-Rod. I just don't see them not being a contender in that division. I really like them.
Yeah, see, I still like them, too. I understand, though, there is a chance for them to crater at their age. You're expecting another big year out of Verlander, which he was excellent last year. Cabrera, excellent last year. At some point, someone's not going to have a great year. Maybe that happens. Royals, by the way, they had 91 losses, and these are updated numbers. What stands out to you, Flan?
Well, you know, we talked about it earlier. It's so hypothetical, and it'll probably look, the numbers changed since our meeting this morning 4 hours ago, so I'm sure they're going to change after
spring training.
They
said they had an issue. All right, in all fairness, right, the numbers changed. I was like, what, did they find some Cubs wins in the ashtray, but which they seem to have done. But they said there was an issue with their projections, and they had to correct
it. I think this year, because of the new bargaining agreement, the collective bargaining agreement, where free agents now will not get compensated. So I don't think players will be held on as long. Like now, Kansas City, if they don't start off right off the top and start off hot, they might move some of their free agents and start a rebuilding process. So,
and that might get them to 91 losses, you're saying. Yeah.
That's where I see that happening, but I don't see that happening with that crew coming back because they know how to win.
The Twins, I mean, again, just at the outset, to think that the Twins are better than the Tigers and the Royals, that doesn't jibe with me right now.
No, it doesn't for me either. The way that happens is what Flanny's saying, the Royals and Tigers were two teams that sniffed around blowing up their teams this offseason because the Royals have a lot of free agents and the Tigers have a lot of veterans making a lot of money. Come July, they're 6-7 games out of even the wild card. You could see them saying, okay, let's trade Verlander, let's trade Hosmer, you know, et cetera. And whatever their record is in July, it's going to get worse probably the rest of the way. Mm-hmm. That being said, it's hard to look at the Minnesota Twins rotation, bullpen, daily lineup, and see a team that is a 500 team, which is essentially 80 and 82. You know, I don't see that no matter what else happens in the division.
Yeah, same here. And again, we'll check back. We'll see. Maybe they're right. Maybe they're not. AL East, what seems to make sense to me at the very top, the Boston Red Sox projected for 90 wins. From there, look, they're really down on the Orioles, 73 and 89 out of it. Again, that'll be on the bulletin board in spring training. They're big on the Rays, and I believed in that rotation last year. It vastly underperformed. It's not the same rotation even this year. Do you think the Rays can be the second best team in that division?
I do think I think Boston's class of the division. Mm-hmm. And then the other four teams, I think you could put it in a bag, shake it up, and convince yourself it will finish 2-5 or 5-2. You know, and
like last year.
Yeah. I think Tampa is in that situation. You know, if suddenly Alex Cobb pitches the whole year healthy and is good, Archer is 2015 Archer, not 2016 Archer. Mm-hmm. I mean, that alone adds X number of wins to them. You know, they have tried to do some stuff this offseason to address the offense. I don't think they're done. I think they'll add one more bat before spring training or during spring training. So if you told me they won 84 games and that was the second place team, yeah. And if you told me it kind of was the same thing as last year and they won 72 games, yeah.
Yeah, I know. Maybe I'm just down on them after expecting more last year, but that offense still looks anemic. The rotation doesn't look near as good. What stands out, Ed, to you?
I agree. I mean, I think the rotation's anemic. The offense is good. I think they're going to be better if they stay healthy, obviously.
All right, Blue Jays. Is that where the Blue Jays end up for you?
Well, I can't understand this 80-win thing. I think they're a very, very solid club. I mean, with Sanchez, Happ, Stroman, Estrada, Liriano pitched very well at the end, very, very well. The bullpen with Roberto Osuna, probably one of the best young closers in the game. Jason Grilli did a great job for us when he came over last year. I was with Toronto last year. Joe Biagini had a great year. And their lineup is very potent. I mean, you've got MVP caliber people at third base with Donaldson, shortstop with Tulowitzki. Devin Travis is an outstanding young player. Russell Martin, you know.
All right, so give me a number of wins. Like, where would you give me a win total, though? Where would you have them?
Well, I mean, if I could have a range, I mean, you have to stay healthy. It's, you know, all those factors in there. I would say they're an 88 to 92 win team.
Okay. Well, let's jump it out there.
I think they're going to win a wild card. This team, Toronto, I mean, they had the best pitching in the American League last year, and they're in a division. That American League East is designed to claw your eyes out in ballparks where the ballpark flies. Baltimore Orioles prove you that. They hit the home runs. They've got to pitch better. But Toronto is still going to have that great pitch, and though they've lost a little bit of their offense, but I still think they can create different ways. to win. Okay. And they pitch in that ballpark.
And again, short of them being bad in July and suddenly saying, hey, we better get rid of Zach Britton, let's see what the market is for Machado. I mean, Baltimore's going to win more than 73 games, right? I mean, they've got great players. Machado is a great player, right? Britton is a great player. You could do worse than kind of Tillman, Gausman. Bundy looked like he was coming on last year. You know, you've got a terrific manager. Obviously, he took a lot of abuse in the postseason for not getting Britton in the game, but that's one game. His body of work says he knows how to get a team into a playoff race every year he manages.
Right. Good point. AL West, meantime, their baseball prospectus big on the Houston Astros. Mariners as well. Seems to make sense. A little low on the Rangers, although, again, the difference between 84 and 87, I don't know. Are you? What stands out to you, Flan? Any of these clubs? What do you think is better or worse?
Look, I know Seattle's got is getting better, and they've got a little bit a little more athletic at times, but I still, those Texas Rangers, when you see 46 comeback wins, that's not, I mean, somebody said, well, they got lucky because they had a lot of one-run wins. That's not luck. That's designed by you know how to do it. And I also believe that Matt Bush might be the closer before it's over with. He might have the best arm there as well. So the Texas Rangers and that ball club, I still think are going to be around.
I'm torn because I hear you on that. I think they're better than their runs scored and runs allowed last year, and yet 36-11 in one-run games, that usually doesn't happen again. I mean, you can think it will happen again. Oh, they're gritty, gutty, they got a good manager, a good bullpen. But even the Orioles did that a few years ago. And the very next year, they didn't do it. So, I don't know, maybe that's a little closer.